A centerpiece of the city of Cincinnati, the John A. Roebling Suspension Bridge has stood for more than 150 years, linking the communities of Covington, Kentucky and Cincinnati, Ohio. With a main span of 1,057 feet, the Covington-Cincinnati Suspension Bridge was the longest suspension bridge in the world when it opened to pedestrians on December 1, 1866. Like many grand challenges, the bridge wasn't easy to construct.
In the 1840s, when John A. Roebling was proposing the construction of this bridge, the Ohio legislature did not really enjoy the concept of having a bridge constructed across the Ohio River, mainly because the steamboat companies were in opposition to having a bridge constructed because it would take some business away from their income.
In the early 1800s, there was really no link between Northern Kentucky and Cincinnati beyond the ferries that connected the two regions. And so there was the Kennedy Ferry that was located close to the point where the Licking River and the Ohio connect. But primarily, getting back and forth between Cincinnati and Northern Kentucky was difficult. And so as early as the 1820s, there were talk about building a bridge.
The drastically changing seasons that rumbled through the Ohio River Valley, along with financing issues and a divided nation facing a civil war, prolonged construction for over 10 years. A nearby suspension bridge over the Licking River in Newport, Kentucky, collapsed in 1854, further deterring investors in the bridge. A nation at war slowed construction in the early 1860s. With Confederate Army threats looming, a pontoon bridge was built to span the Ohio River, allowing Union troops to cross into Kentucky and set up defense. The bridge efforts received a much-needed boost when business, civic, and political leader Amos Schinkel joined the project in 1856. Soon after, investors were convinced of the necessity of having a permanent bridge structure.
Amos Schinkel was really one of the leaders in developing the suspension bridge here in Greater Cincinnati. He really identified the need to connect the two areas. He saw a great impact on the economy. His work as a 30-year-old and a 40-year-old in Northern Kentucky was to raise funds and to get people to invest in the Cincinnati Covington Bridge Company.
Finally, on December 1st, 1866, pedestrians walked on the bridge. Huge crowds marveled at the massive bridge, and over 166,000 people walked across the toll bridge in the first 2 days. The bridge opened for all traffic on January 1, 1867. A driver of a horse and buggy was charged 15 cents to cross. The price for a single crossing for a carriage and three horses was 25 cents. Citizens who wanted to cross the bridge on foot were charged 1 cent to cross.
Back in 1867, when the bridge first opened, that had to be one of the most unique feelings for people crossing the bridge at that time. For a lot of these folks coming out of eastern Kentucky, from Tennessee, coming up north to try to make a living, and when they first spotted this bridge, and for these folks to see this, it was like nothing they had ever experienced in their life. Yeah, there'd be little footbridges, the crossing creeks, but to see something like this, in some senses, for part of the family, it had to be a frightening experience to get across this. And then picture, you know, here all of a sudden that you could take all your pigs, and you're going to take all your pigs to market. And a lot of the slaughterhouses were built right along the river here.
As an area prone to flooding, the city of Cincinnati and many of its Midwest counterparts suffered from numerous floods prior to the construction of the modern dam system in the late 1950s and early 1960s. The largest and most devastating of these floods was the flood of 1937. Nearly 100,000 people were left homeless in Cincinnati alone as the flood affected the city for nearly 3 weeks, finally peaking at over 79 feet, more than 25 feet higher than flood stage. 15% of Cincinnati and 40% of Covington were covered, yet the Roebling Bridge remained open and was the only bridge within 800 miles that remained open for crossing.
In the 1937 flood, of course, that was the highest the river had ever gotten, and to date, the highest the river has ever gotten at 79.99 feet. This structure stood the test of time of all that water, that fast-flowing water and the fury that any flood brings, But the structure itself withstood all that impact, mainly because of the design of the two towers, the towers that sit in the Ohio River. John Roebling designed those towers to be very robust and very stout, and to be able to handle any types of impacts that a flood of the nature that we saw in 1937 and 1997 caused. John Roebling, in his design, knew that if he excavated down deep enough, that any flooding that occurred would not scour or erode the foundation, the soils around the foundations, to jeopardize the integrity of those two towers.
The 1937 flood was really one of the most catastrophic events in the greater Cincinnati history, and the John Roebling Bridge played a key role in that catastrophe. The bridge remained open throughout the flood. During this time period, there was shortages of food, there were shortages of lots of materials that were needed on both sides of the river, and the bridge really allowed people to remain connected. The bridge really was the key in keeping Northern Kentucky and Greater Cincinnati moving forward during that time period. The water during the 1937 flood rose so high and so quickly that it got up to 6th Street and Covington, and even got into the neighborhoods of Austinburg and the West End. And so the damage done to property in Northern Kentucky and Cincinnati was immense, not only to housing, but also to businesses. Many of those businesses had to shut down and were completely destroyed. Many of the people's homes were destroyed. There were stories of homes actually being lifted off of their foundations and flowing down the river.
A private company called the Covington-Cincinnati Bridge Company operated the bridge until the state of Kentucky purchased it in 1953 for $4.2 million. The state collected tolls until the early 1960s, when the Brent Spence Bridge was opened less than a mile to the west of the Roebling Suspension Bridge. Declared a National Historic Landmark in 1983, the Roebling Bridge has been an entrenched symbol for multitudes of art, corporate business, media, and the community as a whole. It is the centerpiece of a city and region that has grown around it as it stood the test of time. The bridge displays a heritage that will be accessible to generations for years to come and provide older generations with a trip back to simpler times and years gone by. Even today, 150 years after it was built, the communities of Cincinnati and Northern Kentucky utilize the bridge for travel, leisure, exercise, and business, all while enjoying its beauty and history. Preserved and enhanced by the Covington-Cincinnati Suspension Bridge Committee, the Roebling Bridge continues to be a remarkable source of pride and enjoyment. It is accessible to all ages and generations and will stand as a centerpiece of our community for years to come.
To learn more about the Roebling Bridge, the rich history of our region, and get help on your history project and research, visit the local history department at the Covington branch or call 859-962-4070. For more information and to view images and bonus footage, visit www.kentonlibrary.org/history.